In this video, we're going to look at how to calculate the percent purity of a sample. We'll start out with the formula, and then we'll apply it on an example. Percent purity tells us how pure a sample is. That being said, we can calculate it by taking the mass of a pure sample, divide it with the mass of an impure sample, times 100. Sometimes the mass of impure sample is just called the total mass of the compound. Let's apply it on a problem. We have 4.98 grams of CO2, produce when HCl is added to 11.67 grams of contaminated CaCO3. That means that 11.67 grams is the mass of impure sample. So we're asked to find the percent purity of CaCO3. The balance equation is also provided. Using the formula, we need to find the mass of pure sample because we already have the mass of the impure sample, which is 11.67 grams. Another piece of information that we're given is 4.98 grams of CO2. From that, we need to find the grams of CaCO3. That's going to be the pure mass, the mass of the pure sample. We start with 4.98 grams of CO2, and then we convert it to moles of CO2. From the moles of CO2, we can find the moles of CaCO3, and from moles of CaCO3, we find the grams of CaCO3. We can't go straight from grams of CO2 and jump straight to grams of CaCO3. We have to go through these steps. So it's going to take us 3 steps in total. So let's start with that 4.98 grams of CO2. We multiply, draw a line across, we place grams of CO2 at the bottom so that it cancels out. Our first step is to convert it to moles of CO2. So we're going to place that on the top. Now we look up the periodic table and we add up the total mass for carbon and 2 oxygen. And we get 44.009 grams for 1 mole. Now that we found the mole of CO2, we can move on to the second step, which is to find the moles of CaCO3. So we multiply, draw a line across, we place moles of CO2 at the bottom so they cancel out. And then we place the mole of CaCO3 on top because that's what we want. To find the molar ratio, we look at the balance equation. The number in front of CaCO3, it's 1. Because it's not written anything, so that means there's 1. The moles of CO2 is also 1. So therefore, we're going to place 1 for each of these terms. And then we proceed to the last step, which is converting it to grams of CaCO3. So we place moles of CaCO3 at the bottom, so they cancel out. And then we place grams of CaCO3, which is what we want. Again, we refer to the periodic table. We add up the total mass for 1Ca, 1C, and 3O. And that gives us 100.086 grams for 1 mole. We do the math, we take 4.98 divided by 44.009 times 100.086, and that gives us 11.33 grams of CaCO3. With that, we plug in the mass of pure sample with what we've just found and divide it with a given mass of impure sample times 100, and we get 97.09%. To recap, in order to calculate the percent purity, we need to first start off with a balance equation. And then after that, we convert from the given information to find the mass of the pure sample. And then we plug it into the percent purity formula, and we're done. Here's a summary of what we did. With that, we're done calculating the percent purity. I have other videos on empirical and molecular formula, percent composition, limiting reactant, and percent yield. I'll place their links in the description box below. Be sure to check them out. Here's a video that I've handpicked for you. Do check out our app that's available in both Google Play and App Store. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you won't miss future videos. Your support means a lot to me.